Fijn dat jullie er allemaal zijn. We kijken vandaag naar een presentatie van studenten Fine Art van de Rietveld Academie. Het was namelijk zo dat de achterliggende 3 weken was hier één grote artist in residence bezig. Studenten hebben enorm hard gewerkt en ze zijn ook nog niet klaar, want na afloop van deze presentatie zullen ze nog een week verder hier werken. En we zijn ontzettend blij dat we gastvrouw, gastheer van deze leuke jonge mensen kunnen zijn. Het alles wordt begeleid door Arthur Kempenaar. Arthur is behalve kunstenaar en lid van de Vishal, ook bestuurslid van de Vishal, maar bovenal ook een zeer gedreven docent van deze studenten. En hij begeleidt ze nou vrijwel 1-op-1. Er wordt heel intensief gewerkt en Arthur kan ook het nodige aan u vertellen over wat u hier allemaal kunt zien. Arthur Kempenaar.
Okay. Now, if you have some time, it takes 5 hours in my explanation about this. Okay, I will do it very short. We start here 3 weeks ago, and during the period, I saw more and more doubt in the volunteers. They were looking around and saw, Jesus Christ, what the hell is happening here? And they saw a kind of mess, and then sometimes a student came in and somebody was working on the roof, a scent, and so on and so on. I have the idea that you can compare it with, let's say, a cocoon for 3 weeks, and at the end a kind of butterfly in all kinds of color was coming out. And now we are here, and I will just say the students who are here and present their work, I will just say a few words about it, and you can lock me. I do it in 2 minutes. Okay. The title, Sweet Dreams, sometimes it can be also a sweet nightmare, or a bitter dream, or whatever. Okay, so it's life. Here in the corner over there, after the white curtain, is Rose Brewer, and she did research after her family. And you have to see that. It's an intriguing project. Naomi van Dijk, she make in a way a mirror of the window by replacing the fence. The fence from outside, see, make a copy of it, and it's inside. Even if you don't, I can imagine that some people don't even realize that it's especially made now for this project. Then Steven Bloomstein, he make this object, that white object, and you can say like an elephant in an elevator, it's it's more about the rest form than about the form. Later you also can ask students if they have to give a kind of explanation of not everything is clear. They are here going around and you can talk with them. They are very polite and human being, yeah. Over there, Yvonne Adriessen, she was busy with an object. During making that object, she had an idea, and during this project, she said, I'm not complete agree with what I'm doing now, or it's not exactly what I mean. And she did a step backwards, and there she present her drawings and her sketches. And so that's also in a way that we are looking perhaps more or less into the kitchen. And so on. Here, Michan Meisberg, Hookers for Jesus. Now, under the church, it's there. Then, over there, it's a maquette of a part of the Vishal. It's by Anne Freistein. And she, her starting point was artist from Haarlem, dead and alive, and to make a new kind of work with the work of that artist who are living here. Over there, in the corner, Maya Wolf. This is a projection with layers. And in front of Maya, there are the guys from Sweden. It's Stig Steiner, Simon Skatka Lindell and Auke Stranelied. And they make the decision that they want to make a sculpture during this opening and in the coming week, the coming Saturday. So in two times from that wood, they built a sculpture. Here, behind the desk, is a light object realized by Rick van der Dood. And he was just hanging it, let's say, now half an hour before the opening. Here, you are standing around. It's perhaps hard to see, but it's there. It's Caroline Hansen, and it's a reaction on parts of the architecture and parts of the element of the visual, and replaced in a complete other setting, and also as an elements are connected to the visual, and at the same time, it's an autonomous piece of work. And here we are standing in the work of Lotte van der Woude, and during this opening she will do a kind of choreography. And or do I say too much, Lotte? No. No. Okay. It's it's this. Petrine Klausen, you can sit on the chair and look up, mm-hmm. and with that both orange form and the transparent and the color of the sky, and there's a headphone, and so you are not only looking to her work, but you will also become a part of the work. Very subtle over there, a yellow balloon. And you can wonder, okay, a yellow balloon, it's simple as that. And during this exhibition, during this process, it will shrink. And it's too long story to tell about that, but it's a part of the exhibition. Here, Hedwig Mikkelsen, she starts in a way playing with sand and formed, we had a discussion about it, that it never should become a sand sculpture, but that it should become a sculpture for itself. And let's say for much more, in the, for the most of the students here, is it's a sort a kind of traject that they are developing and developing during all the time. And so where they start and where they are now, then in that 3 weeks, in let's say the starting base, when nobody was, or when the volunteers didn't see anything, then there was happening a lot. And okay, so Hedwig. Here, Dauphile, and I have to pronounce her family name very correct. It's Alexandra Fio Ute. Dauphile over there. And thinks an alien is interfering or taking place here in the visual. This this object is on the floor, and yeah. Then Jacob Ehrlich, he is making fondue from chocolate, and there's a text above him. And later, I think you can eat some food and chocolate melted by what he's doing there over the table. Then the hands of Einar Lili over there on the ground. In the background, a work by Robert Sommer. He's an exchange, and he took the opportunity to. He said, "Okay, here I have the chance to let's say he is busy with a kind of 2D, 3D painting objects, something in between." And there's another one. It's Eli Sobo. And he was making a work, or he is making a work, and I have it here. It's a kind of, it's called Standing Blind Mockup. And he let a photo print on a piece of textile, but the transport company wasn't succeed in bringing it in time, so he will install it coming week, and it's a pity because it's here you see the sketch, and when you come back you will see a moment here, you will see it in real.
Good reason to come back.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Absolutely. And then a sound object, vision object by Juliet Altona. There in the blue jellyfish kind of thing with this sound. And around the corner is Florina Casti, and you have to go in and have, let's say, a kind of feeling what's going on there. And I don't have the word at the moment, but after I drink, I can explain it better, I think so. And at last but not least is, during these 3 weeks, Nicole Kotman. She was making filling two windows with sand from the beach here. And the influence of the atmosphere outside, the rain, the weather, the wind, make that form, and so she is dealing with perhaps there's another way with what God's hand is doing. Okay, it's I said 2 minutes, I take much more time. I think we are thirsty now, and I want to end but give an applause to the students.